morning, children. How are you? I hope you are well. This is Shobha Rani, English CRT in KGBV, Gudipalli, Chittur district. Welcome to our channel KGBV SS Chittur, Andhra Pradesh. Children, in the last class, we discussed 8th class English, first unit, the tattered blanket. A reading, the tattered blanket. In that lesson, we know that the importance of the human relations. Through the lesson, what we learned in the last video. So, we know very well that the main character, Gopi, how he behaved towards his mother. How he neglected about his mother. So, through that character, through that Gopi's character, we know what are the things we have to do and we have not to do. So, children, in that lesson, the tattered blanket, so we discussed the whole comprehension in the last video. In this video, we are going to learn the things what we come across in that lesson while we are discussed. So in today's class, we are going to learn synonyms, antonyms, and what are the things we come across while we are reading the A reading, the tattered blanket. Okay? First of all, come to the the synonyms. You know very well. What is the meaning of synonyms? Similar meanings are same meaning. Okay? What is the meaning? Same meaning. Synonyms means same meaning. So, in that lesson, the tattered blanket, we come across these all words. So, let us know one by one. What are the synonyms in that lesson? Okay, first of all, synonyms meaning similar meanings. Similar meanings are same meaning, both are same. So, similar meanings. So, irritation. What is the word? Irritation. Irritation means annoyance. Visible definition. Let us open definition. Irritation means visible power. Annoyance. Irritation, annoyance. And the next one is vacation. What is the word? Vacation. Vacation means holidays. You know very well. So you like this word a lot, I think. So vacation is holidays. All the children love very much holidays. Isn't it? Yes. Vacation is holidays. Selavulu. You know? Then the next word, huddle. What is that word? Huddle. Huddle means crowd together. Crowd together. That means ముడ్చుకోవడం. ఇప్పుడు చలి చలి వల్ల కానీ భయం వల్ల కానీ మనం ఏం చేస్తాము? వణుకుతాము అనమాట. కాళ్ళు చేతులు అన్ని కూడా ముడ్చుకునేసి భయపడ్డం కానీ చలి వల్ల కానీ ఏం చేస్తామంటే ఆల్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ బాడీ క్రౌడ్ టుగెదర్ ముడ్చుకొని కూర్చుంటాం అనమాట. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ హడల్, వణకడం. సో ద నెక్స్ట్ వర్డ్ రిలక్టెంట్లీ. రిలక్టెంట్లీ. రిలక్టెంట్లీ మీన్స్ నాట్ విల్లింగ్ ఆర్ అన్విల్లింగ్, బోత్ ఆర్ సేమ్. నాట్ విల్లింగ్ మీన్స్ ఇష్టం లేకపోవడం లేదా ఆసక్తి లేకపోవడం, వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ మే బి. సో రిలక్టెంట్లీ. రిలక్టెంట్లీ మీన్స్ నాట్ విల్లింగ్. అండ్ దెన్ ఆక్వర్డ్లీ. ఆక్వర్డ్లీ మీన్స్ అన్కంఫర్టబుల్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కంఫర్టబుల్. ఆక్వర్డ్లీ మీన్స్ అన్కంఫర్టబుల్. అండ్ దెన్ నెక్స్ట్ వర్డ్ ఫ్యూటైల్. ద వర్డ్ ఈస్ ఫ్యూటైల్. ఫ్యూటైల్ మీన్స్ అన్సక్సెస్ఫుల్. ద వర్డ్ మదర్ ట్రై టు got up from the armchair, but she made futile attempt. So that is the futile. Futile means unsuccessful. Nishpayosham avadam, peddam kavadam. So idu. Then exasperatedly. Exasperatedly means very annoyance. Very annoyance means, you know, the irritation. Not irritation, very annoyance. Ante teevranga visigipovadam, chala visigipovadam. Exasperatedly means. And then mumbling. Mumbling. All you know very well. Mumbling. The old parents make it the sounds very well. So mumbling means speaking unclearly or speaking with low voice. గొనగడం చెప్పాలంటే గొనగడం చిన్న చిన్నగా పక్క వాళ్ళకి వినిపించకుండా మాట్లాడుతూ ఉంటారు అన్నమాట. దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మంబ్లింగ్, స్పీకింగ్ విత్ లో వాయిస్ ఆర్ స్పీకింగ్ అన్క్లియర్లీ. అండ్ దెన్ కంట్రీ సైడ్, కంట్రీ సైడ్ మీన్స్ విలేజ్, పల్లెటూరు. ఎస్, ఇన్ సెవెంత్ క్లాస్ lesson also you know that this word very well. In the town mouse and country mouse. So country, country means village. So these are the minimum synonyms we come across while we are reading the comprehension, the tattered blanket. Not only these words, there are so many words, but I have taken these words only. So the homework is, what are the remaining words which we have learned in the tattered blanket lesson while we are reading? You have to write down those words. Okay children, I hope you are understood well. Okay, and then so the similar words is completed, and then come to the antonyms. You know, and what is the meaning of antonyms? Opposite words. Vyatireka padalu. So antonyms. So what are the words, opposite words we come across in the lesson, the tattered blanket? So unexpectedly. Unexpectedly means they didn't expect. Anukokunda jarigipovadam, anukokunda raavadam, like that. So unexpectedly, opposite word is, or antonym is, expectedly. Mundugane uhinchadam, lekapothe certain plan, having certain plan. So that is expectedly. Unexpectedly, opposite word expectedly. And then suddenly, suddenly, you know, suddenly is something happened all of a sudden. So sudden, suddenly, suddenly and then anukunda jarigipovadam. Opposite word gradually. It will take some time. Gradually is it will take some time. Kontha kaalanga. Kramanga, one by one, like that, gradually. Suddenly, opposite word, gradually. And then, believe. Believe means namakam. Unbelieve. Apanamakam. Namakam, like a word. So, believe, unbelieve. Sharp. Sharp means churukuga unnadam. Like a pote, padinainadi, edaina theesukovachu. Sharp. So the antonym is blunt, mudduvara, mudduga undi anadu. So blunt, sharp opposite word blunt. And then next word, longer. Longer opposite word shorter. Longer means eku time. It will take lot of time. Eku seku. Shorter, tapua time, less time. Longer, shorter. Then, forget. Forget means marchipovadam, unforget. Marchipokapovadam, marchipolekapovadam. So, forget, unforget. And then, terribly, bayangaramga, bayangaramga. Negligible and less important. Less important, tapuvada. దాని గురించి పెద్దగా పట్టించుకోకపోవడం, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ నెగ్లిజిబుల్. దెన్ గుడ్, గుడ్ యు నో మంచి, ఆటోమేటికలీ దెన్ బ్యాడ్ విల్ కమ్ యాజ్ అ యాంటర్. దెన్ కోల్డ్, చలిగా ఉండడం. హియర్ రిలేటెడ్ టు దిస్ లెసన్ కోల్డ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు టేక్ అప్ వార్మ్. చలి, చలిగా ఉండడం. వార్మ్ మీన్స్ వెచ్చగా ఉండడం. వీ కెన్ టేక్ ఆల్సో కోల్డ్ హాట్, బట్ హియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు టేక్ కోల్డ్ and warm. So these are the opposite words we come across in the lesson, the tattered blanket. Other than these words, there are so many words, but I have taken these only for you. So you can note down these are words and you have to learn for the purpose of exam and for daily use also. Okay, so these are the opposite antonyms. So now we have discussed synonyms and antonyms. These are completed. And then we also come across with the question tags. You know, we already discussed while we are reading the comprehension in brief. But now let us know in detail about the question tags. Okay. Okay, children. Let us know in detail about the question tags. Okay. Question tag. Question tag means let us see the definition. Tag questions. Tag questions turn a statement into a question. The tag questions turn a statement into a question. They are often used for checking information that we think we know. Is it true or not? So for that only we are using question tag. So while we are using the statements, whether it is true or false, knowing that in the process we are going to use these question tags. Okay, the question tag definition is, and definition is, see once again, tag questions turn a statement into a question. They are often used for checking information that we think we know. Is it true? Okay, this is the definition for question tag. So the statement ni manaku question ga maarcharam anamata edaina maatladetappudu adi correct kaada ani telusukune vidhanamlo ee tag questions anevi manamu use chestu untam. For example, nuvu annam tinnava, tinnava leda, nenu annam tinnanu, tinnana, so like that, illa correct ga kaada ani telusukunetappudu manamu these question tags use chestu untam anamata. So while making the question tags, there are some rules. Let us know what are the rules for using or making question tags. So first of all, so we have to use comma after the statement before the tag question. So we have to first find out the make the comma like this. So comma, and then we have to find the helping verb in the given statement. But what is the helping verb? So you know helping verbs very well. So is, was, be form, be, all be forms are helping verbs. Okay, is, was, were, like that, these are the helping verbs. So we have to find out the helping verb in the given statement, otherwise we can't make the question tag. Okay, then the third one is we have to find out the negative form in the given statement. So we have to find, is there any negative form or not? If there is negative form, then we have to we need not to mention the negative form in the statement. If there isn't any negative form, we have to mention it in the making sense of question tag. Okay, negative form we have to add while making the tag. Then the fourth one is subject. So in the given statement, we have to find out the subject. Subject means, you know, the person or thing. He, she, it, or names. Gopi or Kamala or dog, whatever it may be, noun forms. So we have to find the subject. And then the subject. What is, which is the subject? Whatever the subject, we have to change into pronoun. If the subject is Gopi, then we have to take, what is the pronoun for Gopi? This is male character, so we have to use he. If Kamala, if the female character Kamala, then what we have to take the pronoun as she. So what we have to take? She. And then if it is thing or other, okay, dog, so then how can we mention it as pronoun? It. So these, he, she, it, these three we have to mention in the question, in the preparing question tags as pronouns. Okay, he, she, it. This is the pronouns. And finally, definitely, it is must and should, we have to add the tag, question mark. So this, we have to add this. So these are the basic rules to make the question tags. Okay? Let us see some examples to understand easily question tags. Okay? I am taking these examples from our A the data blanket itself. Okay, first one, Gopi is in Delhi. Okay, you know this statement well. Okay, Gopi is in Delhi. So what is the first rule? We have to mention comma. So, okay, we mentioned comma as the first rule, and then what is the second one? Helping verb. Which is the helping verb here? Is. Is the helping verb here. Helping verb. Okay, and then negative form. Is there any negative form in this sentence? No, there isn't any negative form. So we have to mention why adding the tag. Okay, there is no question tag. Negative form. And then what is the subject? Subject is Gopi. Gopi is the subject. And what is the next one? We have to take the pronoun for the subject. What is the pronoun for the subject? Gopi. He. Okay. Then finally we have to add the question mark. So here first we have to take helping verb and then so comma and helping verb and negative form. Here there isn't any negative form, so we have to mention negative form and then the subject Gopi. Gopi's pronoun is he and then question mark. That's all. This is the question that is very easy. So is not he. So we have to write like this, but we have to make this is in the into the, we have to change it into the compact form as. So this is called compact form. Forms means short form. Short form. Is it he? Is it he? So is the helping verb and there isn't any negative word, so we have to we added the negative form and the subject's pronoun is he, and finally we mentioned the question mark. So this is the question tag. Okay, is it he? Gopi is in Delhi. Isn't he? Gopi Delhi lo unnadu kada leda, that's meaning. Okay, I think children, did you understand? Okay, let us see one more example. Tell him to send me a blanket. Send me a blanket. So it is quite different than the first example. See, tell him to send me a blanket. So first of all we have to mention comma and then we have to mention, we have to find out the helping verb. Is there any helping verb? Tell him to send me a blanket. No. And then negative form? No. And the subject? No. And then pronoun? Okay. So if, so how can we write if there isn't any subject? How can we add the tag question? So let us see. It's very simple and very easy. These sentences are called imperative sentences. What is it called? Imperative sentence. It means there isn't any subject. There isn't any subject. Ikkada subject anedi manaki lopinchuntad anamata. Subject anedi undadu directly raakade. Aithe but we have to imagine. So if it is, the sentence is in present tense. If it is in past tense. So we have to take the past verb and we have to take the present verb according to the tense. But here in the imperative sentences we have to take just tell him to send me a blanket. If you find these type of sentences, just simply you can write will you tell him to send me a blanket. Will you? చెప్తావా అతనికి చెప్తావా ఒక బ్లాంకెట్ పంపించమని అతనికి చెప్పు ఒక బ్లాంకెట్ పంపించమని చెప్తావా సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఇస్ దర్ ఎనీ సబ్జెక్ట్ బట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు imagine there is subject. So in this type of sentences we have to write the question tags like this. Don't confuse, it's very simple and easy. And then third example, okay, and another example, let us see. You didn't come to see Amma. Who used this statement in the comprehension? Kamala. Kamala is used at the ending of the story. Kamala is asking to his brother Gopi. So you didn't come to see Amma. No, Amma chudaniki raled kada. You didn't come to see Amma. How to change this statement as question tag? Let us see. So first of all, we have to mention, find out, is there any helping verb? You did come to see Amma. No, but here, yes, did is the helping verb here. So did. Is there any negative form, children? Yes, that is negative form. Didn't, did not. So we need not to mention here not. Okay, initially we discussed if there is negative form in the statement, then we need not to mention here the negative form. If there isn't any negative form, we have to mention the negative form. If it is very important, remember that. So you didn't come to see Amma. Did. Who is the subject here? You. You means Gopi, but we need not to mention the name. So we have to, here directly the pronoun you. Did you. That's all. This is the question that very simple. So now we see the negative statement and the positive statement and the imperative statement also. How to change the question tags, right? These statements having before. So this is the question tags. One more, generally, see, I am an intelligent girl. I am an intelligent girl. So how can we change this into question tags? So according to the rules, we have to take question, helping verbs. Am is helping verb here. I is the subject. Okay. Is there any negative form? No. So we have to mention. Then finally question mark. I am an intelligent girl. So here, according to the rules, we have to write like this. But it is wrong. Because when we find the am, I am. So we have, if the sentence is in positive form, we have to take aren't I. So instead of am, we have to take are. Okay? If it is only in the positive statements only, but it is the statement is in negative form, then we can write like this. So okay, I am an intelligent girl. So this is wrong. This is right one. So we have to write like this. So see the negative statement. I am not an intelligent girl. I am not an intelligent girl. So here we can write, am I. Just helping verb is am, and there is negative form, but so we need not to write the negative form here, and the subject is I. So am I. Sir. Am I. So like this. If the statement is in positive statement, we have to write aren't I. If the statement is in negative form, then we have to write like am I. So this is the confusing statements. So that I mentioned here. So children, take it easily and listen again and again until you understand the questions. Okay, this is the basic information about the question types. Okay, write down and write some more. Try to write some more question types. Take from your textbook. There are so many statements, and you check it once and take the statements right. Try to write the question tags and collect it. Okay. Children, see one more information about the question tags. If you find like this, the any statement starts with let's. So then you have to write only one. Shall be. So if the statement starts with let's, then simply you can write like this. Shall be. So let's watch the movie. Shall we? Let's have a coffee. Shall we? Let's have a breakfast. Shall we? Like this. So this is the some rules are there. So many things are there, but these are enough for you. Learn easily. Okay. Thank you. Okay, children. In this lesson, we also observe the pleasure verbs in this lesson, isn't it? So many pleasure verbs we observe in this lesson. This is very important for the exams, and you have to write pleasure verbs meanings, and you have to write the make sentences with the pleasure verbs in the examination. So listen carefully and understand and learn very well. Okay. Let us start. So pleasure verbs. Got down. We know we already know it very well. Got down. So Gopi got down from the from his car at the gate and came towards his mother. Okay, remember? Yes. Got down. Got down means to do something, to begin to something. Start cheyal. Lekapothe raavadam digi raavadam anamata. So car lo unchi atanu digi vastunnadu ani cheppe time lo deenni manam use chestu vacham. Remember? Yes. So got down. Gopi got down. Got down to do something, to begin to something. Okay, edaina oka dani prarambhinchadam leda raavadam munduki raavadam digi raavadam. So digi raavadam ani cheppi cheppukovachu oka rakamga. Digi raavadam. So got down means digi raavadam. Example, Gopi got down from his office car. All the examples I have taken from our text only. So you can understand very well, I hope. So Gopi got down from his office car. Gopi tana office car nunchi digi ekkadiki vachadu tana gate tana inti gate dwara loniki vachadu raavadam manam gamanincham kada. So Gopi got down from his office car. This is the pleasure verb here. So got down. Okay, then get up. Get up means when someone who is sitting or lying down gets up, they rise to standing up. It means evaraina oka kurchoni undadam lekapothe padukoni unnatundi vallu levadaniki prayatnam cheyadam. Levadam kurchoni unde levadam ledhu padukoni undi levadam dani manamu get up ani cheptu untam. So get up means when someone who is sitting or lying down gets up or they rise to standing up. That is called get up. Here let us see the example. Gopi's mother made a futile attempt to get up. Gopi's mother. So evaro somebody is coming through the gate. So she wants to know who is that fellow. That's why she is unable to stand, but she tried to made a futile attempt. She tried to stand, but she failed. Made a futile attempt to get up. Levadaniki prayatninchindi kani levaleka poyindi. So get up. Get up is the pressure verb here. Children, okay, are you able to understand? Yeah. Okay, then the third one is huddle up. What is it? Huddle up. Huddle up means to move కాలు చేతులను ముడుచుకొని కూర్చొని ఉంటామో దట్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ హడిల్ దప్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఎ ప్రెజర్ వర్బ్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ కమల వాస్ సిట్టింగ్ హడిల్డ్ అప్ ఆన్ ద తిన్నా తిన్నా పైన కమల చలికి వణుకుతూ కూర్చొని ఉంది ఓకే ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ కవర్డ్ విత్ మీన్స్ కప్పుకొని ఉండడం ఇట్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ యు కవర్ సంథింగ్ ఆర్ సమ్వన్ అప్ యు పుట్ సంథింగ్ ఓవర్ దెం ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ప్రొటెక్ట్ ఆర్ హైడ్ దెం ఏదైనా ఒక వస్తువు లేదా ఒక వ్యక్తి వాళ్ళని వాళ్ళు కప్పుకోవడం లేకపోతే దాచిపెట్టుకోవడం కోసం ఏదైనా ఒక క్లాత్ ఏదైనా సరే దాంతో కప్పుకొని ఉండడం అన్నమాట సో హియర్ యు కెన్ సీ కమలాస్ హెడ్ అండ్ ఇయర్స్ కవర్డ్ విత్ ఏ థిన్ బాత్ టవల్ సో కమల ఏం చేస్తుంది ఇక్కడ మనకి ఈ లెసన్ లో సో ఒక బాత్ టవల్ తో తన చెవులు తల అంతా కూడా కప్పుకొని వణుకుతూ తను తిన్న పైన కూర్చొని ఉండడం మనం గమనించాం సో దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ కవర్డ్ విత్ కప్పుకొని ఉండడం సో ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ డ్రాప్డ్ ఇన్ డ్రాప్డ్ ఇన్ మీన్స్ విజిట్ ఇన్ఫార్మలీ ఆర్ స్పాంటేనియస్లీ సో ఇఫ్ యు డ్రాప్ ఇన్ ఆన్ సమ్వన్ యు విజిట్ దెం ఇన్ఫార్మలీ యూజువల్లీ విదౌట్ హావింగ్ అరేంజ్డ్ ఇట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ అనుకోకుండా రావడం it is nothing but unexpectedly we can also say that unexpectedly so anukokunda raavadam anamata without any planning so for example gopi just dropped in on his way back so gopi he came for a purpose so what is his arrival's purpose he came for a meeting office meeting at Tiruvananthapuram and the later he came to his home so that is in that also there is a purpose he came for a for his share of property so there isn't any arrangement there isn't any plan to come to see his mother so that is the situation why we are using the present verb dropped in so okay understand and then look after it's very very important everyone should remember that is the present verb look after it means jagratha chusukovadam evarini ante if you look after someone or something you do what is necessary to keep them healthy safe or in good condition ippudu evaraina okati manam ఒక వస్తువు లేదా ఒక పర్సన్ ని చూసుకోవాలి అంటే వాళ్ళు లేదా ఆ వస్తువు జాగ్రత్తగా ఉందా లేదా వాళ్ళ కండిషన్ బాగానే ఉందా లేదా అని మనం అబ్జర్వ్ చేసుకోవాల్సి ఉంటుంది సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సి గోపి డిడ్ లుక్ ఆఫ్టర్ హిస్ మదర్ హియర్ సో గోపి డిడ్ లుక్ ఆఫ్టర్ హిస్ మదర్ వాళ్ళ మదర్ ని తను చూసుకోలేదు అన్నమాట తనకు కావాల్సినటువంటి బాగోగులు ఆమె సరిగా ఉందా లేదా ఇస్ షీ హెల్దీ ఆర్ ఇస్ షీ ఓకే ఆర్ హౌ షీ ఈస్ లివింగ్ those things he doesn't care about his old mother that is called look after so look after means jagratha man chusukovali so that is the meaning of the present verb look after means jagratha chusukovadam so gopi didn't look after his mother the underlying words are called present verbs okay children I hope you understand well what are the present verbs and how we are using these present verbs and when we are using these present verbs I gave you with the definition and with example and see one again and again until you understand the content and try to make in your own use okay children then let us move to the next topic the comprehension questions okay let us discuss the comprehension questions okay okay children let us discuss the comprehension questions which is given in the textbook after the a reading the tattered blanket answer the following questions sir why did the mother recognize gopi and how did he feel so gopi's mother why she didn't recognize gopi while he came to his mother gopi vaalla amma daggariki vachinappudu తన తల్లి తనని ఎందుకు గుర్తించలేకపోయింది వాట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ సో లెట్ అస్ సీ ద ఆన్సర్ ద మదర్ డిడ్ నాట్ రికగ్నైజ్ గోపి బికాస్ షీ వాజ్ లూజింగ్ హర్ మెమరీ
memory power due to old age. Moreover, Gopi has not been visiting his mother for more than 5 years. So, Amma might have forgotten the appearance of Gopi. He felt extremely embarrassed and ashamed of his unfaithful behavior. So, Gopi didn't came to his mother for nearly 5 years. So, she forgot his face, everything. Because she is in old age, she is becoming old and she is losing everything, her memory and her strength, everything. So she is unable to recognize his son Gopi, so that she didn't recognize his son Gopi. So this is the reason why the mother did not recognize the Gopi. And then come to the second question. Why do you think Gopi did not get anything for his mother? So Gopi didn't get anything for his mother. Why? What is the reason? Children, can you guess? Yes, I think Gopi did not get anything for his mother because he didn't find it necessary to get anything for her. Actually, he did not come to visit mother on purpose, but had dropped in his way back from a meeting. So he didn't come to his mother purposefully, because he, and also he didn't think that it is necessary to bring something, food or whatever the things. He didn't find that it is necessary, so that he didn't brought anything for him or for her. So Gopi did not bring anything for Gopi's mother. So this is the So children, look at the third question. The mother could not remember Gopi. Do you think Gopi remembered his mother? What does it suggest? So Gopi's mother, Gopini gurtinchaledu. Tane Gopi tana koduku ani. Mari Gopi tana tallini gurtunchukunnada? Let us see. No, I did not think Gopi remembered his mother. This suggests that Gopi had got too busy to think of mother. This shows his ungrateful attitude towards his mother. So Gopi never think about his mother, and he never thought about his mother because he is too busy with his work. He is unable to write any letter, but his mother is always waiting for his letters and thinks about Gopi. But Gopi never thinks about his mother. He has the attitude of selfishness. He thinks about he and his family only. He never think about his mother. So Gopi Gopi did not think Gopi remembered his mother. So this is the reason. And let us see the fourth question. What is the mean by the expression the tattered blanket? Tattered blanket yokka meaning enti? The expression the tattered blanket means a torn blanket. We already discussed while starting the lesson. Here it indicates old blanket which was completely ragged because it was bought a long time back, which implies the relation between the son and the mother being torn apart due to the unfaithful behavior of Gopi. So ee expression anedi manaki denni telijestadante aa chirigipoyinatvanti blanket ee vidhanga aithe chirigipoyindo alage Gopi mariyu tana tanni madhyana unnatvanti bandham kuda తెగిపోయినట్లుగా మనం ఇక్కడ చూస్తూ ఉంటాం అన్నమాట. సో ద టాటర్ బ్లాంకెట్ అనేటటువంటి ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ దీన్ని మనకి సూచిస్తుంది. అండ్ దెన్ కమింగ్ టు ద నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్, ఫిఫ్త్ క్వశ్చన్. వై డింట్ గోపి ఆన్సర్ హిస్ సిస్టర్స్ క్వశ్చన్ అట్ ద ఎండ్? డూ యూ రిమెంబర్ యువర్ అమ్మ? సో అట్ లాస్ట్ while asking Kamala to Gopi, do you remember your mother? So Gopi asked, so Amma didn't recognize me. Then Kamala questioned Gopi, do you remember Amma? So Kamala question adiginda anamata. Why did you? Gopi answer, Kamala adiginadu, nuvu ammanu gurtinchukunnava sara, amma gurtinchukoledu, nuvu ammanu neeku amma gurtunda ani Kamala adiginappudu గోపి ఆన్సర్ చేయలేదు. వాట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్? ఎందుకు అతను ఆన్సర్ చేయలేదు అంటే, So Gopi did not answer his sister's question because had no answer for the question. His guilt conscience stopped him from answering. He was ashamed of his selfish behavior. So Kamala Gopi's question adiginappudu nuvu ammanu gurtunchukunnava ani adiginappudu Gopi answer cheyalekapoyadu endukante tana daggara answer ledu. సో తను చెప్పాలనుకున్నా కూడా తను చేసినటువంటి ఆ మిస్టేక్ అమ్మ పట్ల తను ప్రవర్తించినటువంటి తీరు తనని ఆన్సర్ చేయనీయకుండా చేయగలిగింది అన్నమాట. సో తనకున్నటువంటి ఆ స్వార్థపూరితమైనటువంటి ఆలోచనలు ఇవన్నీ కూడా తనని మాట్లాడనివ్వకుండా చేశాయి. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద రీజన్. అండ్ దెన్ కమింగ్ టు ద నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్, సిక్స్త్ క్వశ్చన్. ఇఫ్ యు వర్ గోపీస్ సిస్టర్, హౌ వుడ్ యూ రెస్పాండ్ టు హిస్ బిహేవియర్? నువ్వే గనక గోపీ సిస్టర్ కమల అయినట్లయితే గోపీ యొక్క ప్రవర్తన పట్ల నీవు ఎలా రెస్పాండ్ అయి ఉంటావు? సో ఇఫ్ ఐ వర్ గోపీ సిస్టర్, ఐ వుడ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ టు గోపీ ద హెల్త్ కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ అమ్మ అండ్ ద లవ్ ఆఫ్ అమ్మ టువర్డ్స్ హిమ్ అండ్ సజెస్ట్ హిమ్ టు పే ఫ్రీక్వెంట్ విజిట్స్ అట్లీస్ట్ టిల్ అమ్మ ఈజ్ అలైవ్. సో నేనే గనక కమల ఆర్ గోపీస్ సిస్టర్ అయ్యుంటే, సో గోపీస్ మదర్ తన తల్లి యొక్క కండిషన్ అంతా కూడా గోపీకి తెలియజేసి తను ఎలా ఉంది, అలాంటి కండిషన్లో కూడా గోపీని ఎంతగా తను ప్రేమిస్తుంది అన్న విషయాన్ని తెలియజేసి కనీసం ఇకనైనా తనను అప్పుడప్పుడు చూడటానికి తన బాగోగులు చూసుకోవడానికి రమ్మని చెప్పి తనకి జ్ఞానోదయం అయ్యేటట్లు చేసి ఉండేదాన్ని. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఆన్సర్. So children, until that we discussed comprehension questions and phrasal verbs, synonyms, antonyms, everything. So I hope you understood very well. And now coming to the textual vocabulary, so which is given in the textbook. So vocabulary, fill in the blanks with the most appropriate words from the box. Remember, the box has some extra words. Let us see the words: irritation, huddled, awkwardly, futile, vacation, reluctantly, exasperatedly, mumbling. Children, you know we have already discussed in the synonyms these all words, meanings and as sentences. Okay, let us see the questions. All my attempts to make him happy proved. What will be the answer among the options? So the answer may be futile. So it means all my attempts to make him happy proved futile. అతన్ని సంతోషపరచడానికి నేను ఏమేమైతే చేశానో అవన్నీ కూడా నిష్ప్రయోజనమయ్యాయి, వ్యర్థమయ్యాయి. So here the futile is the answer. So futile. And then coming to the next one. The next one, it was very cold, so I dash in a corner. Children, guess what will be the answer? Yes, the answer is huddled. So it was very cold, so I huddled in a corner. Chala chaliga undadam valla nenu oka moolana kurchani unukutu kurchani undipoyanu. So it was very cold, so I huddled in a corner. Okay, then next one. Forced by her parents, Sita dash took the diploma course. Children, let us guess what will be the answer. Yes, the answer will be reluctantly. So forced by her parents, తన యొక్క పేరెంట్స్ తనని ఫోర్స్ చేయడం వల్ల సీత రిలక్టెంట్లీ అయిష్టంగా టుక్ ద డిప్లొమా కోర్స్, తనకి ఇష్టం లేకపోయినా డిప్లొమా కోర్స్లో జాయిన్ అయిందన్నమాట. So this is the answer. Forced by her parents, Sita reluctantly took the diploma course. And then next, fourth one. What are you dash? I can't hear you. Children, you can guess easily. So what will be the answer? Yes, mumbling is the answer. What are you mumbling? I can't hear. మీరు ఏం గొనుగుతున్నారు నాకు వినిపించడం లేదు. మమ్లింగ్ మీన్స్ గొనగడం. స్పీకింగ్ స్లోలీ ఆర్ స్పీకింగ్ విత్ లెస్ లోయర్ వాయిస్. సో వాట్ ఆర్ యూ మమ్లింగ్? ఐ కాంట్ హియర్ యూ. ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్, ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ ఈజ్ ద న్యూస్ దట్ హీ వాజ్ denied promotion caused dash to him. So children, see the what will be the answer. The answer must be irritation. So the news that he was denied promotion caused irritation. Irritation. This is the answers. So appropriate words given in the box. And then coming to the second Roman. Take the words that are similar in meaning to the underlined words. Here some questions are given, and every question there is a underlined word, and also under the question there are given four options. So in those four options we have only one answer is related to the underlined word. Let us see what are the correct answers. His mother made a futile attempt to get up. So his mother made a futile attempt. You know the meaning futile. Futile means here what are the options? Barren, limited, useless, empty. So children, guess what is the answer? Exactly, the answer will be the useless. Take the answer. Useless. Useless is the appropriate or similar meaning to the futile. And then second one. It's all tattered now. What is the underlined word here? Tattered. Tattered. So let us see the options. Spoiled, old, dirty, torn. Spoiled, old, dirty and torn. Then what will be the answer? The answer must be torn. You know, tattered means torn. Torn is the right answer. Okay children, and then come on to the next one. There is a cold mist in the mornings. What is the underlined word? Mist. Mist, you know the meaning? Mist. So, let us see the options. Ice, snow, fog, wind. What will be the answer? It must be fog. Because fog and mist are the same. It means poga manchu. So, there is a difference between snow and fog. This is manchu. అయితే మిస్ట్ ఫాగ్ విషయానికి వస్తే పొగ మంచు అంటాం కదా అది అన్నమాట. సో డోంట్ కన్ఫ్యూజ్ హియర్, ఆన్సర్ ఈస్ ద ఫాగ్. అండ్ దెన్ ఫోర్త్ వన్, ఇట్స్ జస్ట్ లైక్ ఏ బాల్ ఆఫ్ నాటెడ్ యాన్. సో ద అండర్లైన్ వర్డ్ ఈజ్ నాటెడ్. లెట్ అస్ సీ ద ఆప్షన్స్. వెరీ స్మాల్, రౌండెడ్ టైట్లీ, జాయింట్ టైడ్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఆప్షన్స్. అండ్ వాట్ విల్ బి ద ఆన్సర్? The answer will be rounded tightly. You know, knotted means mudi veyadam lekapothe untaga round ga chitti pettadam anamata. So knotted, knotted means rounded tightly. Then coming to the fifth one, I can't make both ends meet with my salary. So let us see the options. Earn a lot of money, spend a lot of money, earn just enough money, give all that one has. So first one, earn a lot of money. Earn a lot of money ante ekku dabbulu sampadinchadam. Spend a lot of money, ekku dabbulni kharchu pettadam. Earn just enough money, kharchulaku taginanta maatrame sampadinchadam. Give all that one has, kaligi unnanta entaithe unda anta kuda icheyadam. So what will be the answer? The answer must be the C. So earn just enough మనీ. సో ఖర్చులకు తగినంత మాత్రమే సంపాదించడం. వినో గోపి యూజ్డ్ దిస్ వన్, ఐ కాంట్ మేక్ బోత్ ఎండ్స్ మీట్ విత్ మై సాలరీ. ఇట్ మీన్స్ ఎర్న్ జస్ట్ ఇనఫ్ మనీ, తగినంత మాత్రమే నాకు వచ్చేటటువంటి సాలరీ సరిపోతూ ఉంది. సో ఐ డెంట్ స్పెండ్ ఎనీ మనీ టు అమ్మ ఆర్ ఫ్యామిలీ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ మే బి. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద vocabulary which is given in the textbook. Children, I hope you understood well.
Okay children, so this is today's class. In this class we have discussed the vocabulary. So first of all we discussed synonyms and then antonyms. After that we discussed question tags. Then we discussed phrasal verbs, the meanings of phrasal verbs and how examples of phrasal verbs and the definitions also. And then we discussed the comprehension questions which is given in the text after the air reading, the tattered blanket and the And then we also discussed the textual vocabulary, appropriate words and the synonyms. So I hope you understand, you listened this all the video and you understood well and learn all the things which is discussed in the video, and don't forget and try to remember and try to use in your daily usage. Okay children, so every day watch the videos and learn something. Okay, in the next video we will discuss the grammar which is given in the text, the noun phrase in opposition, the study skills, listening skill and writing skills, LSRW, all we discussed in the next video. Until that, keep on watching and try to understand and try to learn something, and stay safe, stay home. Okay children, thank you.